हरे कृष्ण। ऑन श्री कृष्ण जन्माष्टमी फेस्टिवल, सो टुडे बीइंग जन्माष्टमी अपियरेंस डे ऑफ लॉर्ड श्री कृष्ण, सो इंस्टेड ऑफ डिस्कसिंग फ्रॉम भगवद गीता, एक्चुअली दिस इज भगवद गीता। भगवद गीता मीन्स द सॉन्ग संग बाय द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड, बट स्पेसिफिकली विल फोकस ऑन कृष्णाज अपियरेंस। वाई डिड ही अपियर और वाई इज ही अपियरिंग? सो इन भगवद गीता कृष्ण हिमसेल्फ एक्सप्लेन्स अबाउट हिज अपियरेंस। सो आई विल शो यू द वर्ड्स ऑल्सो सो दैट यू कैन रिलेट टू इट। सो भगवद गीता चैप्टर 4 वर्स नंबर 5, so Krishna explains, so in the beginning of this fourth chapter Lord Krishna explained that I gave this knowledge to the sun god Vivaswan some 120 million of years ago, and in this way through disciplic succession this knowledge was coming down, but in due course of time it's a great duration of time, 120 million years. So in due course of time this knowledge was distorted, either it got completely eradicated, it was not at all available, or somewhere it was available but it was distorted. So Krishna told Arjuna that I have again come to give this knowledge, same knowledge. Sa eva yam mayati adya yoga prokta puratana bhakto asime sakha cheti rahasyame taduttam. Before that Krishna told evam parampara praptam imam rajarishyo vidhi sakalena mahata yoganashta parantam. I gave this knowledge to Vivaswan. Okay, we'll start with first verse. Shri Bhagavan Vacha. Imam Vivasvate Yogam Proktavan Aham Avyayam Vivaswan Manave Praha Manurikshvakya Vyabravit. I instructed this imperishable science of yoga to the sun god Vivaswan, and Vivaswan instructed it to Manu, the father of mankind, and Manu in turn instructed it to Ikshvaku. So Krishna explained this science to sun god Vivaswan. The name of sun god is also mentioned in Bhagavad Gita, Vivaswan. And Vivaswan gave this knowledge to Manu. Manu is the personality whose descendant are human beings. That's why man, or in Hindi we say Manushya or Manav. Just like sons of Pandu Maharaj are known as Pandav. Similarly, every human being on this earth planet, we are known as Manav because we are descendant of Manu Maharaj. That's why we are known as Manav, or Manushya also because we are part and parcel of Manu. Means we are descendant of Manu. That's why Manushya. Or in English also, they say man. So the same thing. Or human. It is coming from Manu. So the father of mankind. So Manu instructed this knowledge to his son Ikshvaku, and Ikshvaku was the first human being or king of earth planet, and in the dynasty of Ikshvaku Lord Ramchandra also appears. So in this way this knowledge was coming down, but Krishna says in this way evam parampara praptam, in this way and by disciplic succession this science of Bhagavad Gita was received, but sa kalena mahata yoga nashta parantapa, but in due course of time the succession was broken and therefore the science as it is appears to be lost. So in due course of time this succession transmission of knowledge was broken. That's why Krishna again sa evayam mayati adya yoga prokta puratana bhakto asime sakha cheti rahasyam he taduttamam. That very ancient science of the relationship with the supreme is today told by me to you because you are my devotee as well as my friend and can therefore understand the transcendental mystery of this science. Sa eva ayam maya te adya, by me, O Arjuna, the same knowledge is being delivered to you today. The same yoga prokta puratana. Puratana means the old, that same eternal, oldest knowledge. That means this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, which Krishna spoke to Arjuna 5000 years back, it's not actually, it was manufactured or it was created 5000 years back. This knowledge was already there. Krishna confirms this in Bhagavad Gita, in this verse, Puratana. So in this way, Krishna gave. So after hearing this, Arjuna asked this question, the sun god Vivaswan is senior by birth to you. How am I to understand that in the beginning you instructed this science to him? Vivaswan is very senior by birth to you and you are my contemporary. So how you instructed this science to him? How to understand? Then Krishna started explaining his nature of his appearance and purpose of his appearance. Both these things Krishna explains himself from verse number 5 to 9-10, and that is actually basis of Krishna Janmashtami. So with these verses we'll try to understand what is the significance of Krishna Janmashtami. So Krishna says, Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Bahuni me vyatitani janmani tav cha Arjuna tanyaham veda sarvani natvam vetha parantapa. So Shri Bhagavan Uvacha, one instructing interesting thing is when Arjuna speaks in the Bhagavad Gita, it is said Vyasadev is writing Arjuna Uvacha. When Sanjaya speaks, Vyasadev writes Sanjaya Uvacha. But when Krishna speaks, Vyasadev doesn't write Krishna Uvacha. What he writes? Shri Bhagavan Uvacha. That means Krishna is not just ordinary personality. Krishna is not just as one among others who are speaking Bhagavad Gita. Krishna is Shri Bhagavan. He is the supreme personality of Godhead. And another point, Srila Vedvyasji wants to instruct us by writing Shri Bhagavan Vasha, that now whatever confusion may be there, different rishis, different munis, sages, and different philosophers, they may have different opinion. Because every intelligent person, they have some kind of opinion about truth. So they may have different kind of opinion, but what is exactly truth is spoken by Sri Krishna himself. That is the significance of using the word Sri Bhagavan Vacha. That means here the Supreme Lord is the greatest authority, supreme authority is speaking about the truth. So whatever he speaks, that is completely true. Whatever he speaks, that is dharma, that is religion. Whatever he speaks, that remains absolute truth forever. And there is no question, nobody can ask any question about whatever Krishna speaks. That is the meaning of this, using this word, Sri Bhagavan Vacha. So anyway, so Krishna is telling, Bahuni me vyatitani, many, many births, both you and I have passed. I can remember all of them, but you cannot, O subduer of enemy. Krishna says, my dear Arjuna, both you and I have passed many, many births, but I can remember all of them, but you cannot remember, although you are subduer of enemy. Subduer of enemy means Parantapa. Means Arjuna was so expert, so powerful that he could conquer over any kind of enemy. Arjuna was so powerful that he could even defeat demigods. What to speak of human beings on earthly planet? He was powerful enough to defeat any kind of demigods or any demons. In fact, Arjuna fought with Lord Shiva also. So Lord Shiva became very pleased with Arjuna by seeing his fighting spirit and his power and his focus, his self-control, his purity, All these things impressed Lord Shiva so much so that Lord Shiva gave his personal weapon, Pashupat Astra. So that was the caliber of Arjuna. So, but in spite of having so much strength, so power, and everything, so intelligent, Arjuna was very intelligent also. Although he was a Kshatriya, so definitely he was very powerful. But at the same time, he was very intelligent as well. Because the same Bhagavad Gita, which we are right now trying to understand, let's see how many days, rather, we should say, how many years it takes us to understand a little bit portion of Bhagavad Gita. So it is also very doubtful. And many, many great scholar, philosopher, intelligent person, they give their entire life just for understanding Bhagavad Gita, but still they are unable to understand it. But Arjuna could understand entirety of Bhagavad Gita just within 45 minutes. Krishna spoke Bhagavad Gita at the battlefield of Kurukshetra in 45 minutes. And Arjuna was so intelligent, he could understand everything. And finally, he did what Krishna wanted him to do. So that was the intelligence of Arjuna and his strength. He was so powerful. Everyone knows how powerful Arjuna was. And he was so focused. Everyone knows how he pierced the eyes of the bird, and how he got the hand of Draupadi in her Swayamvara. It was a great challenge, but Arjuna, because of his focus and concentration, he could win that challenge, Swayamvara ceremony. And Arjuna was a very self-controlled personality also. Generally, those who are Kshatriyas, those who do Kshatriyas are generally in the mode of a mixed mode of passion and mode of goodness. And mode of passion, known as Rajoguna, causes one to enjoy sense gratification. All these lusty desires appear in our heart because of the influence of mode of passion. But those who are in mode of goodness, by following religious process, by following sadhana, proper sadhana bhakti, so they can uplift their consciousness from mode of passion to mode of goodness. And in this way, they are able to subdue, they are able to control their lusty desires. But Arjuna, although he was a Kshatriya, those who are Kshatriyas or kings, naturally they have mode of passion, because that is required also. Mode of passion is required to challenge somebody, mode of passion is required to fight with somebody, to argue with somebody, that is required. But those who are Brahmanas, generally they are peaceful. They don't argue with each other, anyone. They don't become angry so easily. So these qualities are there because of mode of goodness. And because Brahmanas and devotees, they are situated on the platform mode of goodness, so they are able to easily control their lusty desires. But Arjuna, although he was a Kshatriya, but interestingly, because he was a great devotee of Krishna, so at the same time, for the sake of Krishna, he could conquer all the enemies. She was fighting like anything. He was just so, he became so passionate to kill so many millions of soldiers at the battlefield of Kurukshetra. But the same Arjuna, he was also very much self-controlled. He could conquer all lusty desires. So that was the qualification of Arjuna. When Krishna took Arjuna to heavenly planets, so Indra offered, Indra, Arjuna is son of Indra, because Indra gave Kunti Maharani, Arjuna as his son. So, and Arjuna was so powerful. And because of Arjuna, Krishna came to heavenly planet. So Indra, being pleased with Arjuna, she offered the best of the damsels, best of the apsaras in Urvashi, known as Urvashi, to Arjuna so that he can enjoy with her. But as soon as he came, Arjuna immediately offered Dandavat Pranam. Arjuna said, "My dear mother, Mataji," instead of saying Urvashi Devi, Arjuna said, "Urvashi Mataji." So that was the level of his self-control, and he did not associate with her. And because of this only, Urvashi cursed Arjuna that you will have to become impotent for 1 year, And of course, that was Krishna's plan. And Arjuna used this in Krishna's service when he was in Agyatvas. He became Brihannala, a teacher of this Uttara. He became Guru of Uttara and he taught dancing. Arjuna was a good dancer also. So he taught dancing to Uttara. So later on, when it was revealed that Uttara, Arjuna, after Agyatvas. So after 1 year, Arjuna again became Kshatriya warrior. So this was the thing. So Arjuna was so control, so powerful, so expert, and so intelligent, so self-control, and Arjuna was so very soft-hearted also. So all the good qualities were present in Arjuna's heart. That is why Arjuna could understand. But the same Arjuna, Krishna is saying here, although you are Parantapa, you are very powerful, everything is there in you, all the good qualities, but still you cannot remember all your births, but I can remember all my births. So what is the mystery? What is the thing? Why Arjuna cannot remember all his births, but Krishna is remembering? So Krishna explains in the next verse. Krishna says, Ajo apisan avyatma bhutanamishvaro apisan. प्रकृतिम स्वामधिष्ठाया संभवामि आत्माया. सो कृष्ण सेज दिस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वर्स. एवरीवन शुड नो दिस वर्स, स्पेशली विथ रिगार्ड्स टू श्री कृष्ण जन्माष्टमी. कृष्ण एक्सप्लेन्स द नेचर ऑफ हिज जन्म. इन प्रीवियस वर्स कृष्ण सेज, कृष्ण सेड, बहूनि मे व्यतीतानि जन्मानि, मेनी मेनी जन्म, मेनी मेनी बर्थ आई हैव टेकन अर्जुन. बट वॉट काइंड ऑफ बर्थ? We are also celebrating this Janmashtami, we say. But what is this Janma? Krishna's Janma or birth is not like us. He's not forced to take birth. And he does not become miserable. It's not that when an ordinary child takes birth, he cries a lot. And he's forced to take birth. But Krishna appears or takes birth out of his own sweet will. And when he appears, he's so beautiful, and he with a smiling face he appears. I'll show you the photo. Lord Krishna takes birth. Lord Krishna, when he appears in the prison house, but he's not like ordinary person. When he appeared and he was very nicely smiling and giving fearlessness, because his parents, Mother Devaki and Vasudev, they became very fearful when Krishna appeared, because Mother Devaki especially, she thought, oh, this child who has taken birth is so beautiful. And Krishna appeared, he was wearing pitambar and morpang, peacock feather, and he had so nice curly hairs, locks of curly hairs, and she was wearing kundal and lotus eyes and all the amulets, jewelries, everything. He appeared like this and he was smiling like anything, very nice, beautifully smiling. His smile was decorating his lotus-like face, which is already so beautiful. It defeats the beauty of millions of moons. Krishna's beautiful face defeats the beauty of millions of moons. And even on that nice moon-like face, this beautiful smile decorates it and makes it more beautiful, more attractive. So both Vasudeva and Devaki became very much attracted to Krishna's beauty. And at the same time, Devaki and Vasudev, they became very pleased and attracted to Krishna, baby Krishna, who just took birth. But immediately at the same time, they were experiencing such a great intense anxiety and fear, because they were thinking that now my brother will come, Kamsa will come and take this child also. So this fear was there within the heart of Mother Devaki. So immediately Krishna could understand that my mother is so fearful, so let me show her my opulence. Who am I? So immediately Krishna became 400 Narayana form. He assumed the 400 Narayana form and holding Sankh Chakra Gada Padma, standing in front of them and illuminating all the darkness of the prison house. And then he started speaking to Mother Devaki and Vasudev, and he started enlivening them with his transcendental knowledge. He explained to them that the three births before each both of you performed such a severe austerities just to get me. And I appeared before you, and you took the benediction that I should become your son. But I became so pleased that not only for one birth, I granted this benediction that I will become your son for three births. So in this way, I have appeared again. This is my third birth, Krishna says. So don't worry, Kansa will not be able to do any harm to me. You don't worry. And then Krishna spoke to Vasudev that you just carry me to Gokul, and you put me aside Yashoda Maya. She has given she has also given birth to a daughter. So you exchange with her. You put me there and you bring that girl here. So in this way, Krishna instructed, and again he assumed the small baby form. But still, because of the innocence and child and the beauty of baby Krishna, Devaki was experiencing still some fear, some kind of fear. But then Vasudev took Krishna and very safely he gave Krishna to Yashoda Mata. And then finally, so this is the nature of Krishna's birth. Krishna's birth is not ordinary birth. So in this verse, Krishna explains, Ajo api sanna avyatma. Ajo means, although I am unborn. Ajaha means, ja means one who takes janma. Aja means one who does not take janma. So Krishna is Aja, he is unborn, he never takes birth. Api, although I am unborn, still I appear. Avya, avyatma. My body does not deteriorate, but still I appear. So then when you appear, so what is the constituent of your body? What it is? So Krishna says, Prakritim Swam Adhishthaya. When I take birth, so I appear in my own transcendental or spiritual divine body. So the body, the darshan which we take of Krishna, Tribhanga Murati, Nanyata Prakasham. So his beautiful form is not material. His body is not made up of earth, water, fire, air, ether, like us. His body is completely spiritual, his own internal potential. Sambhavami Atma Maya. Atma Maya means by my internal energy, I appear. So this is the mystery of Krishna's birth. We should know. So today is Krishna Janmashtami. So then why do you appear? What need is there? What is your purpose? Then Krishna explains in next verse. Yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyutthanam dharmasya tadatmanam srijamyaham. So this is the purpose. Two purpose. In two verses, Krishna will explain the purpose of his appearance, why Krishna is taking Janmashtami, and we are celebrating Janmashtami. So with this purpose, we will be able to understand what is the significance of Janmashtami and how we can celebrate Janmashtami in a best possible manner. Simply by going and breaking on Dahi Handi, you don't celebrate Janmashtami. It's just a fun. It's just our own sense gratification. So many people, they don't even know. They think Janmashtami means Dahi Handi. Dahi Handi jaake pholna hai. That's all Janmashtami. Many people don't even know that Janmashtami means it's Krishna's birthday. That's such an unfortunate situation. So, they celebrate Janmashtami. How do they celebrate? Dahi Handi Podke. Okay, no problem with Dahi Handi. You can celebrate like this. But don't forget the purpose. We should know the purpose also of Krishna's Janmashtami. Why is taking birth? So, whenever and wherever there is a decline in religious practice, O descendant of Bharata, and a predominant rise of irreligion, at that time I descend myself. So whenever, yada yada, whenever and wherever the dharma is going down, decline in religious practice, dharma goes down, and irreligiosity is rising, at that time I descend myself, I myself appear to re-establish the dharma. That is the purpose of Krishna's appearance. So now what is dharma? Dharma means our obedience toward God, our service to God. Dharma means our duty towards God. Dharma is not just Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Isai. Dharma is not just in the name of God or in the name of a religious activity, we do only our own sense gratificatory activity. That is not dharma. That is just wearing the garb of dharma and doing all kinds of adharma. That is not dharma. Dharma means with heart and soul together, one is inclined to serve the Supreme Lord. One is inclined to develop love for Him. One is inclined to render service to Him without any material motivation. That is dharma. Specifically to love Him. That is dharma. So to establish this dharma, Krishna appears. So now, can anybody of you tell me, how does Krishna establishes this dharma? When he appears, so what he does to establish dharma? Yes, who can tell? Please tell, or you can write in the chat box. How does Krishna establish his dharma after taking birth? What he does? Yes, who can tell? In this way, Krishna establishes dharma. Krishna establishes dharma by speaking Bhagavad Gita, by giving Bhagavad Gita. Because in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna explains to us that what is our real duty, what we are supposed to do, who God is, who we are, and what is the purpose of life. All these things are principles of dharma. So that is, they have been explained by Krishna in Bhagavad Gita. So if you really want to celebrate Janmashtami, then what you should do? You should take firm vow that I must listen to Bhagavad Gita, I must read Bhagavad Gita, I must try to understand Bhagavad Gita. So anyone who can understand Bhagavad Gita, that means he has really celebrated Janmashtami. That means he has really taken care of Krishna's appearance. Krishna is coming with this purpose, that he wants to impart this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita to every one of us. So if anyone who is serious about trying to understand Bhagavad Gita, that means he is with Krishna. He is aligning his desires with Krishna's desires, and he is trying to please Krishna. And in this way, he is celebrating Janmashtami. So in this Janmashtami, you can give best gift to Krishna, or you can best possible way, you can serve Krishna by yourself reading and understanding Bhagavad Gita, and by trying to spread this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita to others. That means by connecting others also to this wonderful course, Bhagavad Gita, the manual of life. So if you do this, that means you have celebrated Bhagavad Gita very nice, Krishna's appearance very nicely. That is the best celebration of Janmashtami. So in this verse, Krishna explains, it will establish dharma, I appear, and then by doing this, what he does, two things are taken care. When Krishna appears and he speaks Bhagavad Gita, these two things happen. Paritranaya sadhunam vinasaya shudushkritam dharma santapanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge. That I appear to deliver the pious and to annihilate the miscreants, as well as to re-establish the principles of religion. I myself appear millennium after millennium. Paritranaya sadhunam. Those who are sadhus, means those who are devotees, by speaking such a wonderful Bhagavad Gita, Krishna gives knowledge to devotees, good souls like all of you. He shows the way how you can lead your life so that you will remain protected while living in this polluted material world, while living in this material world which is full of so much crime, so much nonsense things, sinful activity, criminal activities. And so many demonic kind of people are living around us in this society. So Krishna gives protection to us by giving knowledge to us, Bhagavad Gita. And by this, Krishna destroys Vinashaya Dushkritam to annihilate the miscreants. What are the miscreants? Miscreants are not just present externally to us. Miscreants are present within our own heart. What are those miscreants? Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Mad, Matsar. These are miscreants. Dushkritam, who force us to commit sinful activity, who force us, who deviate us from the principles of religion, who makes us forget the Supreme Lord Krishna, the only worshipable, lovable object of everyone's life, everyone's soul, everyone. So that is because of this Dushkritam, anarthas. And these anarthas, Dushkritam, they are generated. They take birth because of ignorance, ajnanata. And this ignorance is destroyed by the light of knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. The darkness of ignorance is dissipated by the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. So while Krishna, when he speaks, when he takes birth, he appears. So he speaks Bhagavad Gita. And by reading Bhagavad Gita, understanding Bhagavad Gita, the soul, good souls are protected, and all their anarthas, Dushkritams, miscreants within their heart are destroyed. In this way, the true religion of serving Krishna, loving Krishna, that is completely established. And for this purpose, Krishna appears. This is the reason. And finally, Krishna says in 9th verse, Janma karma cha me divyam evam yo veti tatvatah tyaktva deham punarjanma naeti mameti suvarjuna. One who knows the transcendental nature of my appearance and activities does not, upon leaving the body, take birth, his birth again in this material world, but attains my eternal abode, Arjuna. Krishna explains this. Like my janma, my appearance, my birth, and my activities are all transcendental, or divya, or divine. It's not ordinary activity. The way I take birth, the way I act in this world while remaining in this world, it may appear like ordinary person, but actually it's not ordinary. Whatever activity I do, that is also completely different, and in nature, that is completely divine, transcendental. My birth is also completely divine and transcendental. So anyone who can understand the mystery of my birth and activities after leaving this body, he's not coming back to this material world again. Rather, mameti, he attains me. In this way, his life becomes successful. So with this, we shall stop. So thank you very much for kindly joining this most auspicious occasion of Sri Krishna Janmashtami. So we pray to Sri Radha Das Vihari that all of you may be able to understand the principles of Bhagavad Gita and successfully complete this course, wonderful course, Gita manual course, and take full advantage of knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, by becoming a pure devotee of the Supreme Lord Krishna. Thank you very much, Hare Krishna. So if there are any questions, you can ask Hare Krishna. Yes, Sri Pro, a question. Why every individual's mind is wrapped with the thin film of rigid Maya? Why does God doesn't want us to remember our past lives? Yeah, very good question. So your first question, why everyone's mind is wrapped with the thin film of rigid Maya? Actually, not just thin film, it's a very, 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 very thick film of Maya. It's not just thin film. Because, and the reason is because we have been trying our full, we have been trying to the fullest extent to enjoy our sense gratification in this material world from the last many, many, many births. And because of this, activities which we have performed, sense gratification activities which we have performed from many millions of births, so many impressions, bad samskaras have been stored within our mind, our heart. And because of those impressions, we have developed so deep attachment for again and again, again and again, enjoying sense gratification and committing all kinds of sinful activity. And that is why we have become accustomed. It has become our second nature. Subconsciously, every living entity who has accepted this material body, subconsciously means naturally he is inclined to enjoy sense gratification. And this is the reason why we again become, again and again entangled with the activities of Maya. So this is the reason. So that's why, but there is no discouragement. Although our position is very precarious in this material world, we are so much entangled with the activities of karma. But we have a great hope, and Krishna is giving us a great hope. If we can simply understand the philosophy of Bhagavad Gita, and in this way become fully Krishna conscious, take shelter of Krishna, then we can overcome all kinds of Maya. There is no doubt about it. Krishna explains this in 7th chapter, verse number 14. Tevihesha mama mayi mama maya durataya mama eva ye prapadyante maya metam tarantite. This Maya is my own energy. It's Krishna's personal energy. So it's very difficult to overcome. But one who has surrendered to Krishna, one who takes shelter of Krishna, he becomes completely free from this Maya. Because this Maya, which may be very powerful, but it's Krishna's energy. So Krishna can control that Maya. And his mind is the greatest agent of Maya, using which Maya deviates us, distracts us, and we become entangled in this material world. But one who takes shelter of Krishna, so Krishna can order, oh my dear Maya, please relieve this great soul. He has become Mahatma now. So please relieve him. He is no more Maya Das. He is my Das, Krishna Das. So if you become Krishna Das means if you take shelter of Krishna, then by Krishna's mercy, it's very easy to become free from Maya. It's not very difficult. And one can very easily control his mind and senses. That is very much possible. So this is the answer to your first question. And second question, why does God doesn't want us to remember our past lives? So this is because we desire to enjoy in this material world a lot. So if we remember our past life, so we will be unable to continue our business of sense gratification. Because we will become very much depressed by remembering our so many past bad incidents. So it will be very difficult for us to lead our present life. Suppose if you were a king in your previous life, you had all the opulences, everything, all the facilities, but now you are struggling hard just to maintain your life. So if you remember that in your previous birth, you were a great king and so much opulence was available very easily to you. So how will you be able to just survive in this world, in this life? It will be not possible. That's why it's Krishna's mercy that he makes us forget our previous, all kinds of previous bad and good situations so that we can continue with new chapter. Sometimes when a student fails in the exams and he has done something very bad, so parents or teachers, they say, okay, now forget whatever you have done. Don't worry. Now start a new chapter. So that we can go ahead. That is the reason. Okay. So, next question. Which devotees? Okay, awesome.